Our team coverage continues now with how people are coping with a very unwanted Christmas present, rebuilding their homes. WDSU reporter Blake Hansen is in Pearl River County and is live for us with what they have to say, and I can imagine not good, Blake.
Yeah, Camille, it's hard to believe, but we are coming to you from the third floor of Ted and Cindy Williams' home. This is the area we've seen some of the most extensive damage along Highway 11. And like many other families in this area, at this hour, family and friends are out trying to help this family pick up the pieces of their lives.
This is pretty much what we came into.
Moments like this.
Yeah, you found our stockings.
Filled the day at Cindy Williams' home. On a day when most families are looking through Christmas presents, they were looking for memories.
So excited. We found our stockings.
When the tornado hit, the Williams had family over for Christmas. The home was leveled, Christmas decorations hurled into trees, Christmas dinner thrown into the yard.
God definitely was taking care of us because we were not harmed.
The Williams home was one of 17 destroyed in Pearl River County Wednesday. 8 people were taken to area hospitals with non-life-threatening injuries.
Some of these homes were leveled to the slab on Joe Smith Road, so it looked like toothpicks. I mean, we're very fortunate not to have any fatalities. I mean, we're real blessed.
This house isn't just a home for the Williams, it's also a home for a lot of the neighbors around here. During Hurricane Katrina, it served as a safe haven for around 30 people, and it's a topic that still to this day makes Cindy emotional.
I can still cry about Katrina because all of our friends that were from Slidell, my sister-in-law, they brought their friends because they like didn't think it was going to hit there, and then they lost like everything, you know?
While many look at the devastation and see a Christmas tragedy, Cindy Williams sees it differently.
When you look at where everything's hit around us, it's just, you know. So, no, I think it'll be always my most grateful Christmas ever, you know.
The attention now has turned to the cold weather in this area. We've been feeling the temps drop as we've been here from our 4 o'clock to our 5 o'clock live shot. Pearl River County has set up some shelters for those families, some still without power tonight. We are on your side in Pearl River County, Mississippi. Blake Hansen, WDSU News.
All right, Blake, certainly an emotional time for those folks affected. And the National Weather Service sent crews to McNeil, Mississippi earlier today to determine what category tornado hit that area.